Chris, did you happen to see Anthony Joshua's announcement yesterday? Anthony Joshua, did you happen to see his announcement? He said, I got an offer to host a heavyweight championship, but he didn't mention the name of an opponent, which I thought was a little interesting. Wouldn't you mention who you're fighting?
Of course.
So I'm thinking it may be Dillian White, it may be, and Fury's now in Vegas. Interesting. Maybe it's Wilder Fury 3. Deontay Wilder and Fury, third fight? I like Deontay, he's a good dude.
Yeah, he's cool. I have nothing bad to say about him.
I think Malik Scott's gonna be the head coach.
You know Malik? Coach?
For Wilder. Or one of them, he's gonna coach with JD's. Chris Arreola, 3 weeks out from Andy Ruiz's fight. He's in great shape, great spirits. Another week. It's Monday, it's work. Did you happen to see James Toney and Shannon Briggs going at each other with a meme war?
No, I did not, man. I don't pay too much attention to all that stuff.
James Toney said, how do you say it? Lights out, light work. And he put a picture of Shannon Briggs, like he's light out, and I'm lights out, he's light work. And Shannon Briggs put a picture of the Michelin man, like James Toney. They may fight.
I'm good for a fight, to be honest with you.
Shannon
Briggs was a pretty good heavyweight.
Yeah.
And James is just good, period. I like James. James is a good dude.
Yeah,
so is Shannon, man. He sent me messages before and encouraged and stuff, which is very rare sometimes in the heavyweight division. Usually, any division for us.
No, boxers, you don't always get that support. You always get the haters, and people you thought would support you actually are the ones hating.
Dude, I got a message on Facebook. I got a message, huh? And guys like, man, you've changed, man. The whole family wants to see you, blah, blah. Like, who are you? I don't know you, bro. Like, what are you talking about? Man, fuck you, you fucking bitch. I was like, what the hell?
Who are these people?
I don't even know who he is. And the guy talking about his family, I'm like, dude, family doesn't talk to family like that.
But that's funny. But Shannon sent you a nice message. That's cool. He's a good dude. He has good energy. Man. Let's go, champ. Yo, do you remember when you were chasing Klitschko and ate his sandwich? And
that was fun. You eat what I eat. I eat, you eat.
No, the funniest one is when Klitschko was out on the board in the middle of the ocean.
Yeah.
That was
the best. He runs a boat, and then he falls in the water, and he's like laughing at himself.
That was the best one.
That was hilarious.
Shannon, yeah, him and James Toney are having a meme war. They're going at it. You can look at it later. You'll laugh. But James Toney's training every day. He's getting in shape. And Shannon is always in shape.
Shannon is always in shape.
You ever seen him?
I have more or not.
He's in the movie The Transporter. He has a fight scene.
Gonna have to watch that movie.
You haven't seen The Transporter?
Nah.
It's about some dude driving an Audi. Jason Statham, whatever his name is.
Statham,
yeah. You ever watch The Sopranos?
Nope. I'll watch episodes here and there, but I wasn't a Sopranos guy.
What movie do you see that was good?
Nobody.
What is it about?
It's kind of like an Equalizer kind of movie, but he actually gets his ass kicked here and there, you know what I mean? Unlike, Denzel comes on stage, this guy actually gets his butt kicked, gets stabbed.
It was more realistic.
A little more realistic. He's still like, come on, suck my kid. But it's a lot more realistic, though.
Chris, would you ever do any acting? Would you ever be in any movies?
If the opportunity came, hell, do shit.
I mean, you're in L.A. There's a million opportunities here. You could play the good guy, the bad guy.
Or just the muscle.
Play the muscle guy.
Don't worry about that. I tried that a bunch of times.
Yeah, Joe is very good friends with two very famous actors. Mr. T and Adam Sandler.
Yeah.
What's your favorite Adam Sandler movie?
I like Happy Gilmore.
That's a classic. That's a real good one. Happy Gilmore. There was one called Bulletproof that wasn't bad. Bulletproof? Damon Wayans, Adam Sandler?
I like Punch
Drunk. Oh yeah, I remember that.
I like Punch Drunk as well. I like Wedding Singer, Billy Madison, you name it. I like all of them.
You know, you ever seen the movie 50 First Dates?
Yeah.
When every time I meet Magic Johnson, it's like that. He's like, and you are, and who are you? I'm like, dude, I've interviewed you 5,000 times. But Adam never did a boxing movie, right? Oh, don't mess with the Zohan.
Oh, it's funny. No, 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 no. Sonny Gatz. Sonny Gatz.
Oh, actually, his best movie ever is not a comedy. Uncut Gems. I don't know if you saw that one.
Oh, yeah, that was super good.
I hated the ending.
The ending was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I hated
that. I was watching it, literally me and my wife were like, what the fuck?
But, you know, I know people in the jewelry, they really like that, into basketball and gambling. Like, it was, I think it was based on a true story. Like,
really?
Something like that. Maybe on true events, not a true. Like, it's based on real people, I think.
Yeah, that's crazy to hit a parlay like that too. Especially right off the bat, you have to win the tip.
Oh. Yeah, but people are sometimes, if you're that much of a gambler, I just pick like winner. I can't pick like.
Yeah, I can't do that either. I can never do that. It's fun, but I ain't gonna bet no big money. I probably put like $10 in one of those.
Yeah, parlays. The house always wins, Chris.
Yeah.
You work so hard for your money, you don't wanna give it away. People always call me for gambling advice for boxing, and I always get it wrong.
Really?
I mean, it's hard to know who's gonna win.
It is.
Obviously, there are some fights that we kind of have an idea, but. Do you have any friends in the heavyweight division? Anyone you're really cool with? Not really, you're cool with everybody.
Yeah, I keep it cordial, keep it respectful with everyone because, shit, we're all killers in this division, period. So why make enemies? I just fucking hate, what the fuck's that, Molina guy. Hate that motherfucker.
Eric Molina?
I will slap the shit out of him if I see him.
Why?
He's disrespectful. He's fucking, has no class. Can't take an ass whooping like a man.
You beat him, right?
I whooped his ass in the first round.
Why would he be mad? It's over.
Yo, I don't know. Fuck him.
I thought he just had a fight or he's about to fight.
And he got knocked out too.
In England, right?
So yeah.
There's one heavyweight that's coming up, 19-0, 19 knockouts. Chris Lovejoy.
Yeah, I heard of him.
He's a cool dude.
Yeah.
He was supposed to fight the White Rhino and the fight fell through.
The White Rhino?
Some
isn't
guy
he
from
old?
England. Yeah, he's retired now. But I think honestly, Bruce, we've seen the heavyweight division come back.
Yeah, definitely.
For years it was like on the back burner, it wasn't respected.
Because of the Klitschkos.
They killed it.
Yeah.
Boring, 1-2, no excitement, dry. Nice people, but dry.
All they wanted to do was win, and which is, with all due, it was perfect for them, but not perfect for boxing.
Not for the division.
Yeah.
And now, look, you have Wilder, yourself, Dillian Whyte just came back, avenged his loss. Andy Ruiz. There's a lot of talented heavyweights right now. Usyk is doing good too.
Usyk is someone that people should really pay attention to because I personally believe he has carried over his power from the cruiserweight to the heavyweight division. And he has the boxing skills that most heavyweights don't.
I want to see him and Joe Joyce. That'll be interesting. Mm-hmm. And I think Joseph Parker just won, right?
Yeah.
He's also very
good. In New Zealand. But Joe Joyce versus Usyk is actually a pretty entertaining good fight. Joyce is a big rookie. Because he really is a rookie. He's new to boxing.
But he's doing it right. What do you mean, new or not new? He's winning?
Yeah, he's doing exactly what he's supposed to. He beat a fat Stavern. Fucking Stavern.
When you fight them, they're in the best shape ever. What do you think about King Kong Ortiz?
I like him. I like his style. I like how he fights.
Southpaw?
Yeah, and he's very in the pocket. Stays in the pocket for the most part. Good fighter. Fun fighter too.
Chris, what happens if Wilder fights Fury again?
Fury wins.
Why?
He already got his number. He had his number the first fight. He just got caught.
Well, that's what it takes with Wilder. You could catch him in the third fight.
Yeah, it happens, but I personally think he had his number already from the first fight.
What about if Joshua fights Dillian White rematch?
Joshua.
Okay, Joshua Fury?
Fury.
Why?
Fury's just a dog. Yeah, he's a dog and he has poor man syndrome, you know what I mean? Meaning that he's willing to fucking hustle, he's willing to take a punch, he's willing to go through hell to get a win. I'm not sure Joshua is, you know what I mean? To be honest with you, I haven't seen that out of him. My respect for him because he's a good fighter, but I personally think that Fury is just a dog. He's willing to do what he has to do to get a win.
What do you think of F.A. Ajugba? Just had a huge knockout.
Who?
F.A.
Ouch.
Tall guy fought on PBC.
I didn't watch it.
He had a very good fight with the guy that used to train here. Doesn't train here anymore. Yago, Kilatse. Where they both dropped each other in the same round twice.
Yeah, I didn't watch it.
You didn't
it.
See that one?
Nah.
That was a good fight. Yago got dropped. They thought it was over and he dropped F.A. Then F.A. dropped him. It was a good exchange.
Those are always fun fights, right?
Yeah. Like Corrales Castillo was like that. You know, Joe was involved in that fight.
Of course.
They call it fight of the century.
I watched that fight in Rosarito. I remember watching
when it was
that
live?
Fight.
Live. How old were you?
18, 19.
You were a kid.
I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I remember watching the Rosarito though. Hmm. Probably 20. I was probably 20.
That was a great fight. Yeah. You were pro yet? Not yet?
No. I had already won the National Gold Glove, but I didn't turn pro yet.
Who are you going for in that fight?
What you gonna call it, Diego? I was upset when he got dropped twice. I was like, no!
He shocked the world. He did it.
Yeah. I still remember that day. I have pictures of that day too. Well, not like of the pic, but of that day of everyone that was watching it. I have pictures of that.
Why do you think they love boxing so much in Mexico? I mean, they're great in soccer.
Well, in soccer, it takes a lot of variables in order for you to be good or to be considered a great pro. You have to be a team player first and foremost. You gotta know how to play with the team. You gotta be able to be humble and pass the ball and stuff like that. And boxing, it's a poor man's sport, but you rely on yourself. You put everything on yourself. Either you work hard or you don't work hard, and it's gonna show in the fight. And that's why I believe Mexicans love it so much, because it's a one-on-one sport, a one-on-one combat, and it's about what you bring to the table, not what the team brings to the table.
And look at the success over the years.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about like old history. Look at Chavez, considered the greatest ever.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have Morales, then you have Marquez, and Oscar Valdez just shocked the world. He was a two-time Olympian with the Mexican team.
He didn't shock me. What shocked me is the way he fought and how he stood in such control the whole fight. And he stayed in the pocket. And he stayed with the fucking the game plan. Because there was plenty of times that he could have gone crazy and gone to war with Brichel. But he didn't. He stayed in his game plan.
And now him, by the way, you heard about this? You know who Gervonta Tank Davis might fight next?
Who?
San Antonio kid, 140 champion. Tank's the champ at 130, 135, and he might move up to 140 to fight Mario Barrios. It's a tough fight.
For who?
For both.
It's a good fight.
But I'm saying, I brought up Tank because they were talking about Tank and Oscar Valdez. That's a very interesting fight too. Two champions.
Arthur, come in around. Yo, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Not in boxing, Chris. No, there's a, I'm not gonna say a lot of fakers, but there's a lot of ways in boxing today where people can hype up a fighter, promote him, but he doesn't have anything behind it. And we see it.
Like we say, they get those TJ wins,
yeah,
or the Midwest wins. Take them up to the Midwest.
In Europe, they take them to Bulgaria and they fight people. Tyson Fury has a brother. And his brother fought a guy that was 12 and 112. Yeah, like he has 6 wins and 9 wins, and is 0 and 11, 0 and 13, 2 and 26. But that's how you build a fighter, right?
Sort of. You know, because at the end of the day, those fighters ain't, sometimes they haven't been tested and ain't worth the shit. I know a lot of fighters that go and get paid and go pay to get a win just so they could get a better fight out here.
I think Henry told me a story once that he was in TJ and some manager was mad because his fighter lost, and he said, but we were guaranteed a victory.
Ain't shit guaranteed sometimes, man. Motherfuckers, even though they're like,
you would think
fighters, they're gonna come to fight.
By the way, did you see the video of Canelo doing squats with like a shitload of weight? I was impressed.
I don't watch all that stuff.
You're too busy. You're focused right now.
You know what? My respect is going to everyone. That's why I don't follow nobody. I don't follow nobody because, no offense to them, I really don't care.
That's a lot of weight though.
That is a lot of weight. That's a shitload of weight. What is that? 90? 180? 360, 405 with the bar?
Yeah, 45.
Wow.
That's not easy. You do squats?
Yeah. I don't do that kind of stuff. I don't need to put all kinds of weight. I'd rather do a set of 15 and do 5 of those.
Is that because of COVID? You need your own speed bag?
No, just got a little drunk.
Chavez Sr. told me recently he never did speed bag and he never did mitts, ever. He said, I don't know how to hit the speed bag.
I don't remember if he did mitts. I do remember watching him do mitts.
Maybe just a couple times when he was with Emmanuel Stewart, but that's it. Travis Sr. never did mitts. Travis Sr.
No. He did heavy bag.
Yeah, heavy bag and sparring. Thank you. By the way, Chris, were you a fan of DMX?
Yeah, man.
Passed away at a very young age. 55 is super young.
Look, man, my respects go out to him, his family, love his music, but I don't feel sorry for someone that overdoses.
Why?
No, I understand that they have a problem and stuff like that, but yo, man, you're playing with your life when you're doing that. Why? You're always playing Russian roulette when you're doing drugs, especially hard drugs like that. You're messing with your life. So, do I respect him? Do I love his music? Yes, but do I feel bad? Not so much, man.
If that's the case.
I feel bad for the family. For the family, for the people that loved him and lost him. But it's hard to feel bad for someone that died over an overdose. It's very hard for me. Very hard. Respect the man, respect the family, condolences go out to the family and everyone that loved them.
What was your favorite song? Rough Riders, I like that one.
Rough Riders is always the best one.
DMX.
Party Up.
Party Up.
Yeah.
What's my name? Say my name, what is it?
He had a lot of bangers, man.
Mike Tyson walked out of one of his songs.
He had a lot of great, gritty songs that come from pain and come from the hood. Hey. That it's very relatable.
Chris, you know the story how Rafael Arreola got into boxing?
Rafa.
Yeah.
How'd you get into boxing?
I actually gave him.
He was a 12-year-old kid and he came with his brother to sell candy. Never boxed before.
And
both he and his brothers became world champions.
Well, I knew that part, but I'm saying, like, after selling candy, what made you guys box?
I never asked you, did you buy any candy from here?
Did you buy any candy from Gabriel when he came in here to sell you candy?
Yeah.
Because he hid himself very much, you never
know. No, he gave Gabriel stash his candy in the bushes.
And Joe didn't want to train him in the beginning, and they were very persistent. And, you know?
You got it right, Joe.
Well, I mean, you know, you got a 12-year-old kid in there and you're trying to make a living. It's not exactly the most exciting prospect.
But yeah, made them both champions from scratch. Not every coach could do that.
Nope.
Well, I'm very thankful they convinced me.
Yeah, it's like, you know, I was against YouTube, believe it or not. I had a friend who was a reporter at the LA Times named Valerie Gutierrez. And she says, there's a brand new website. You got to put your videos on this. I'm like, I'm a professional. I don't put my videos out there for free. And she convinced me. Imagine if I was stubborn. I said, no, forget YouTube. Sometimes you have to, like, you know, listen.
It's tough sometimes, though.
Yeah, it is. Now it's out of control with TikTok and Instagram and Twitter. I can't keep up.
I was wondering anyway. See, you have Lomachenko. When did he fight again?
Lomachenko started training again. He wants to fight Nakatani, the guy who just knocked out a Puerto Rican guy. Verdejo? Wait, who did he knock out? I think Verdejo.
I still think he's going to be the best fighter in the world.
Lomachenko is one of the best fighters. And,
pound for pound, shit. He may have lost, but
in boxing, they're so quick to write you off, Chris. One loss and everything you did in your life is evaporated. That's wrong. It shouldn't be like that. Look, the Dodgers could lose 80 games and still win a championship. Lakers could lose 30 games, still win a championship. Why in boxing you can't? And it's not normal not to lose. Everybody loses in every sport. MMA, boxing.
Okay, Because we're only one person.
Yeah, it's true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I think also the media, they love to build you up and kick you when you're down.
Yeah, it's just, of course. How you handle that after.
Yeah. Oh, he got exposed. He was a bum. He was always a bum.
Ain't that the truth, right?
Look, they're fighters that win four division champions, and they break them off.
Right. So crazy.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, Loma was brave enough to be great, man. That's what he was doing. He was trying to be great.
Yeah, going for his third division, a fourth division.
Yeah, well, ain't nothing wrong with that, man. Just because he went to try to be great, now he's a bum, now he sucks. What the fuck? That is stupid. That is crazy, man. That is so crazy.
He was a three division champ in 12 fights. I remember.
Just like Terremoto too. See, yeah. Like people wrote him off.
Leo, four division champ. Yeah,
like, just because he lost to fucking Tank. Just a better night. The other guy had a better night. That's it, man.
But Tank, exactly. Tank's a monster.
How are you going to write someone off just like that, man? It's fucking stupid. Yeah, when he's up, you're like, yeah, let's go, Mike. Yeah. What the fuck? And then he loses, like, that's kind of just what pissed me off.
But look, MMA fans.
Fans like that, man.
But Chris, in MMA, the fans love you whether you win or don't. They stay by you. Same thing with the Lakers or the Clippers. The Clippers haven't won anything ever. And they have a big fan base.
They got selfies, though. They got a bunch of selfies on the floor in Staples.
Yeah. Do you go to NBA games?
You know what? I don't go to NBA games. They're those too pricey for me.
Josecito goes to a lot. I see them.
Dodger game. We're a Dodger game this Sunday, yesterday.
Did they win? Yeah, they're
in they won.
3 out of 3, right?
3-0 or 3?
Yeah, 3-0.
Yeah, they swept them. Yesterday was Kershaw and, what's his name? Schwarzer. The one with the crazy eyes. He had one eye, one color, and the other guy, different color. It's pretty cool, actually. I wish I had that eye.
You could get anything today you want, Chris.
All right.
I'm sure there's a doctor in TJ that will make both of your eyes look whatever you color you want.
I'm okay with that.
There you have it, everybody. What's your Instagram, Chris? People want to follow you.
Chris Arreola.
Make sure to follow him. Stay tuned. 3 weeks out from his big fight with Andy Ruiz. You don't want to miss it. At the StubHub known as Dignity Health Center with fans. Going down May 1st. Please, this is going.com. Let's get back. Report.